On this, we're going to talk about an offset. Taking a straight piece of pipe, and we got to put two marks on that pipe. Now, in order to figure out where those marks go, we got a couple things to think about. One is design. And as a conduit bender, you actually have a little bit of design in yourself. You get to choose what works best based on the what you're trying to get the rays to equal. We have suggestions, and our go-to, once we get to the 3-inch obstruction and beyond, we want to stay around a 30-degree, bend. The reason why that is, two 30-degree bends equals 60 degrees. And two 45-degree bends equals 90 degrees. The less bends we can have in a conduit, the easier we're going to be able to pull the wire through the conduits. So we want to minimize the bend as much as possible. And using a 30-degree is our go-to solution. Why is that? If you look over here, kind of got this grid over here that talks about what our multipliers are. Our multipliers is what we multiply our measurement of our obstruction to be. Like if this obstruction, let's say it was 5 inches. If it was 5 inches, okay, and we were going to use 10-degree offsets or 10-degree bends to make an offset, we would multiply 5 inches times 6. Well, 5 times 6 is 30 inches. So our A and B marks would be placed 30 inches apart, and that would leave a lot of open air right here next to what we're trying to get to. Our 22.5 is kind of an oddball. If we're going to a 22.5, most people would rather just go to a 30. There's a reason for a 22.5 for some certain purposes, depending on your design and your wishes. But your multiplier for a 22.5 would be 2.6. If this is 5 inches, 5 times 2.6 equals 13 inches. So our measurements between A and B would be 13 inches. And that would get us a little bit closer on this open air gap here. But a 30-degree is so simple, and it's so easy for us to remember. Your multiplier is 2. If this is 5 inches, and I'll go ahead and write the 5 inches over here, our multiplier is going to be 2. So the math would look like this. 5 inches times 2. Well, obviously, that's very simple. You didn't even have to write that down. Equals 10 inches. So from A to B, our marks would be 10 inches for a 30-degree offset. So that's what I would choose, and that's what I suggest that you guys would choose as well for a 5-inch offset, to use 30-degree bends. There's going to be 2 bends, and there's 2 marks, and they're opposite each other to make an offset. Now, where do you start? You're going to have an A and B mark, and this is up for, again, suggestion. Some people will say different than what I'm going to suggest, and some people will have a reason to start at a different place. I'm going to suggest that we start at 3 inches from the end of the pipe. The reason why that is, the bender itself has some meat between where the angle starts and where the bend hook actually connects. And that's about a little bit more than 1¾ inches for a 3/4 inch. And if we're real close to that end, we can actually egg shape that circular conduit and make it not circular anymore, kind of make it look like an egg at the end because we're too close to the end. 3 inches is a safe start point that I suggest. You have the option to choose something different, or you may be required by other people over you saying, hey, I want to start it at 2 inches. I just suggest at 3. Now, if we started at 3, we're going to put a mark at 3 inches. For this 5-inch obstruction that we're looking at, our multiplication was 5 inches times 2, which is 10 inches. So from mark A to mark B would be 10 inches. And everything references off of mark A. That is one thing that in all conduit bending, once you establish where mark A is going to be, all other measurements refer back to mark A. And to bend this, once we established our A and B marks, right, that are 10 inches apart, again, I suggested starting at 3. We'd bend the first bend with our hook, the same orientation as we measured, the hook of the bender, the hook of the tape measure. You put this on the arrow on the bender. You would bend this to 30 degrees, right, going this way. Then you just spin the pipe around and slide it through. And what it ends up being, it changes the orientation to the bender being like this. And then you would bend the second bend at 30 degrees, and it will equal an offset. A lot of times, the first time people start bending, they'll not spin it around and actually bend two bends the same direction. You got to make sure you bend them the opposite directions.